God, episode, ladies and gentlemen, episode 36 of the Drewcast. I'm back, baby. I'm back. I'm glad to be back, guys. Last couple weeks, I have been having guests on, and now it's by myself again. So, but yeah, next week will be the 2-year anniversary video, and we have one come back on, guys. One of the original creators of Say What's Real, and yeah, it'll be good. We were supposed to do it today, but. Some fucking, you know how life is, bro. Sometimes life, that's what we should just make shirts like that, Asen. Sometimes life just, sometimes, you know what I mean? Or something stupid, bro. Like, sometimes life just fucks you raw, bro. You know, you know what I mean? Sometimes life just, oops, now the car starter's out. Now you have to put, you have to dip into your savings. Now, sorry, Emily, no more help, no more retainers for your teeth. We got to get a starter. You know, bro, has that ever happened to you? Like, when you and Kylie are saving something, right? And then all of a sudden it's like, hey, now we can't do it. Now we can't do it. Now we got to dip into our rainy day savings. Like, what's the most, no. You don't even have to say it if you don't want to, but what is like the time where it's like, hey, I was saving for this and now I can't do it because oops, I gotta get my wisdom teeth removed.
I think it was like 2 years ago. We were supposed to go visit Dooney in California. Something happened with the TV. So we had to buy a new TV instead of taking that plane trip.
For anybody who's listening and you want to know what a Dooney is, it's not a fucking emu or a fucking zoo animal. It's my brother. That's his nickname we gave him as a kid. I don't know where that nickname came from. It's a horrible nickname too, by the way. Our family's so notorious for that, bro. Like, mom... We have a fucking little brother named Chow. You know what I mean? Like, it's crazy. Because I don't know what to call him. I'm not going to call him by his dad's real name. You know, because him and his dad have the same name. Because mom has no originality whatsoever. Like, you know what I mean? We talked about this before. Like, oh, my first daughter's name is Zoe. What can we name the second daughter? Chloe. You know what I mean? Then mom had to have taken like fucking 5 seconds to come up with that. That took no more than 5 seconds of thought. You can't tell me that. I love you, mom. I love you. But you can't tell me that took more than 5 seconds of thought. That's like, oh, the first son's name, Justin. What do you want to name the second son? Bustin. You know, fucking Dustin. Oh, yeah, Dustin and Justin. That's what it's like, mom. Did you not think? Like, bro. And mom came up with my name. Like, we're in the middle of the, like, mom's pushing me out her vagina. And like, oh, there's a hurricane hitting Florida. What do you want to name your son? She's looking at the TV. I guess Hurricane Andrew. I mean, Andrew. I guess Andrew. And then, you know, mom tries to tell everybody it's like from the Bible, you know, like some, she's trying to be sweet to everybody. Like, oh, I named him after the Bible. You didn't, mom.
She's never said that, has she?
Has she?
I don't know.
I thought she did. Maybe just making shit up. I don't know. You guys know not to believe me anyways. I'm not, you know what I mean? I'm not like a fact check machine. So I don't even know how to start this off, bro. Like, I want to get into the Bill Cosby shit with you. Because that is crazy. That's fucking insane. So you were telling me last night that Bill Cosby didn't actually get out because he's innocent, right?
Mm-mm.
You told me he got out off a technicality that they, because they fucked up when they were like trying him. Now, I actually don't think that's what happened. I think it was just like the people or the powers to be were like, hey, this guy has to spend some time in prison. And at some point, we're going to get him out one way or another. Because it was just, you know, when you go on social media, bro, like, you know what sucks about that kind of stuff? Is that this is exactly what ended up happening. This guy was like, he was out here like drugging and raping women, right? Against their will, like drugging them and shit. And then you legit had real people. Like, real people online were saying, like, oh, he didn't rape those. What? How many women you said came up forward? Let's just say it was past 30, because I know you said, like, some fucking crazy number. It
says 60.
60 women, okay?
It says, for context, Cosby has been accused of sexual misconduct or rape by more than 60 women.
That's insane. That's insane. And we have a live audience tonight, too. Emily, shout out everybody. You know, I mean, she's sitting there fucking chilling. She said she has AirPods, and I don't know. I don't really believe her, but... So we are going to sit there. Okay, 60 women, okay? That's a lot of women, bro. I mean, I personally don't even know 60 women. Okay? And if we're going to be real, I don't think I've even met 60 women in my whole entire life. Okay, I'm just being honest with you. I don't think I've met 60 women. So, one of the cringiest things, though, it was like people turned it into something it's not. Okay? So people were like, oh, it's because, you know, some of those fucking people on Facebook that were like, he's because he's a black man and he tried to buy NBC and they're trying to take down a black man. It's like, no, it's because he drugged and raped women. Can it not just be that, dude? Why does it have to be something else? Why does it always have to be something else, bro? Like, you know what I mean? Like, bro, it's not that he drugged and raped a bunch of women. It's because he's a black guy who tried to buy NBC. It's like, come on, bro. At a certain point, I made a status about this earlier this week. Do your research, bro. Do your fucking research, dude. Okay? One of the reasons I never liked Bill Cosby, by the way, and this is before the whole drugging and raping thing was going on, but you can tell when a lot of his fellow comics talk about him, he wasn't really pro, like, he was pro-black, but he wasn't really, like, you know, he would always shit on Dave Chappelle and Eddie Murphy and, like, all these people who, like, cussed in their stand-up sets. You ever hear about that?
No.
Like, you ever hear those guys talk about that? Like, oh, Bill Cosby didn't like that, so he would down-talk us. Eddie Murphy's one of his biggest, like, Eddie Murphy always kind of talks shit about him. Because it's like, hey, who are you to judge, bro? You know what I mean? You're out here drugging and raping women, but guess what? I can't say fuck in a stand-up set. Is that what this is? No. You see how garbage that is? This guy spent all these years drugging and raping people while married, by the way. Okay? And then he has the audacity to tell other comedians, and especially the black comedians, that you can't cuss in your stand-up set. But I can go and drug women and rape them. It's fucking garbage, dude. It's garbage. But yeah, so over 60 women, he gets out on a technicality. What do they do from here? Like, that's just something I just don't understand what they do from here. What happens? Does he go back to work?
I'm pretty sure he's as free as me and you. From what I'm reading, it says that...
Is he still charged with anything?
No, everything just got thrown out. And you know, since...
Well, because the court of public opinion is on his ass.
The United States of America, we have a double jeopardy rule, so he can't be charged again for it regardless, so... He's free and he'll just remain free.
Okay, the one thing we could take away from this, if we have anything to take away from this besides the fact that, like, you're a fucking gross piece of shit, is that, like, white people... Dude, no other race of people does that for each other. I can't think of one. Like, when Harvey Weinstein got caught with all that nasty shit he was doing, white people weren't like, oh, no, it's because he's white and tried to buy ABC. Oh, no, Harvey Weinstein tried to buy Hollywood. That's why they did this to him. Like, when that shit happens, we're like, no, bro, it doesn't matter what you look like. You're disgusting. You know what I mean? But someone has to stick up for somebody. Like, you know when OJ, the thing happened with OJ? And people were like, hell, like, you know, Grandma Debbie told us that. Like, people were, like, scared to, like, say he was guilty because, like, people were hella mad. It's like, bro, I don't know, bro. That's just disgusting to me. I'm interested to see if, like, any outlets like Vlad TV or I don't think they would, but, like, any outlets do interviews with them. I wouldn't, bro. Like, that's I wouldn't touch the Bill Cosby interview, dude. What the fuck do you expect him to say? I wish I could do a great Bill Cosby impression right now because I'd fucking smoke it. But, like, what else do you expect him to say? But, yeah, again, on this show, yeah, no Bill Cosby for us, bro. And, in fact, there's a big problem happening right now with that type of stuff.
Well, in this thing right here, it says that he admitted back in a 2005 case that he was giving quaaludes to women he was pursuing for sex. Okay. So, therefore, that's technically rape, yada, yada. But that whole case back in 2005, when he admitted that and everything, I guess the DA and the people that he was working on the case with, they told him that he wouldn't be charged for that case.
But he was still charged for that
case. So they told him that, and he walked away in 2005, and they were trying to recharge him for that again up in this 2018 case.
And that's where the
whole technicality lies, technicality is that they're, yeah.
Oh, it's not because...
Long story short, I mean, it's a bunch of other shit, but...
It's not because he's a black man trying to buy NBC. Because I swear, if you look at social media, I swear that's what it is. That's what it is, if you look at social media, bro. That's the point, bro. That's the point. You know what R. Kelly, too? With R. Kelly, they say the same thing. No, bro. It's not because you're black. It's because you fucking rape women.
And then,
and you have sex with minors. They do the same thing with R. Kelly, bro. It's okay, bro. It's okay if you say, I like R. Kelly's music. Okay? You can say that. You're an adult. You can say that. You could say, hey, I like the Bill Cosby show. I grew up watching it. You know, it set a good example for the black family. That's good. You could say that. But when you start making excuses for, like, rape and like having sex with minors by saying, oh, no, those girls are lying. They're just trying to tear a black man down. That to me, bro, is like, bro, I don't know what to call that, actually. There's a word that I want to say, but it's the R word. And Josh isn't here to say it. I wish Josh was able to say it. That's why I said on Facebook the other day, do your own research, bro. Do your own research. I can't, like, bro, imagine if, like, one of, like, you have a daughter, you know, I have a girlfriend, we have sisters, nieces, whatever, bro. What if someone in our family got, that Bill Cosby did that to them? And then you have people out here like, oh, he tried to buy NBC and that's why they tore him down. No, it's because he drugged and raped my sister. Can you imagine, bro? We had a little taste of this earlier this year, okay? We had a little taste. Remember the Walmart incident with the mask? Yeah. And every news outlet ran with there was an anti-mask thing when it wasn't. That was just a small taste of how the media can turn something and make it go viral. And everybody in the world thinks it's this when it's not that. It's not that. It's just kind of cringy.
The last thing about that, though, is there was 60 accusations, but I guess there's a statute of limitations for 12 years.
So some of them couldn't get...
All of them. That's why, you know... Like, oh, but
how is there a statute of limitations on that kind of stuff? I don't get it.
But I mean, it's 12 years, so I mean, I guess...
I mean, maybe I'll have to look into this and do more research, because I've been spewing to people to do more research. But, like, if you rape somebody, you're telling me that if 12 years pass, I'm not getting in trouble for that rape anymore. Is it because of the lack of evidence, or I'm not...
I have to do more research as well. But I know that that's a rule, and they all went longer than that, so their cases really don't hold any weight against them anymore.
Yeah, I kind of... Not that I want to get off this subject, but it's just like, bro, there's nothing to talk about here. Like, you're a piece of shit, dude. It's not because you're black. It's not because, and you're not funny either, by the way, so you're not funny. It's just because you're a piece of shit, bro. This is just plain and simple. But yeah, I know this is kind of like a very switch change of topics, but have you been hearing about the whole Britney Spears thing that's been going on?
Mm-hmm.
So last night, when me and you were playing King's Corner together, Emily had sent me a meme, not a meme, Emily has sent me a picture that I guess like a judge denied taking her dad off the conservatorship, but it had nothing to do with her recent admission in court. You heard the audio of that, have you? It was her. It was like a leaked audio of her in court, and she was basically explaining like, "Hey, my family doesn't do anything about this. Like, they've been living off." You know, it was very, very alarming. Actually, I think it was like the first time you actually heard her speak about the conservatorship, and when you, it's kind of fucking sad, bro. It's to the point where, like, bro, like, are we gonna? So we freed Bill Cosby. Right? But Britney Spears is still stuck under a conservatorship where she's forced to have a... Emily, what's the word? You know that thing they have for women? That you can't get pregnant? What did Britney say she has? She's forced to have in her? IUD? Maybe that's what it is.
Something
but
like that.
And if I get the name wrong, we'll put it in editing. But she's forced to have that. So she can't get pregnant. It's like, bro, at some point, bro, like, people are gonna have to realize, like, that's... How is that legal? That's fucked up, dude. And, like, they're saying she's not mentally fit to do this and this, but she's mentally fit to do tours. She's mentally fit to do shows and make you guys money. See, I don't know. And then her sister, Jamie Lynn, got hella, like, she got hella feedback, too, because she went on Instagram Live. I think it was, like, an Instagram Live video, or she posted videos to Instagram talking, like, oh, this doesn't affect me either way. I just want my sister to be happy. Like, I don't get how that doesn't affect... You know what I mean? Like, if that was happening to you, and I said, oh, this doesn't affect me either way. Sorry, my cat who doesn't pay rent wants to fucking meow the whole time. It's fucking ridiculous. But anyways, you've done some... You know some of this, right? Like, you've been hearing about some of it, right?
Just like headlines and stuff.
Headlines and stuff. My thing is like, bro, I just want to know how it's legal. Like, how the fuck is this even legal to do it to somebody? To do this to somebody. Should I not do it to somebody? I sound like Borat. But you know what I mean? Like, it's crazy. So I'm hoping things start speeding up with this case, because like, now that it's getting like nationwide attention and worldwide attention, like, yeah, bro, like, that's weird. It's weird. So Britney and all the fans, I hope you guys, I hope Britney gets this shit over with. I hope her the sucky thing is, bro, is like, her family's probably not going to do any time for this. Like, they did hella fucked up shit to her and nothing gets to happen now. They just gotta walk free from this now. That's the fucked up part. The justice system is so fucked, bro.
They probably took so much fucking money from her, too. I remember seeing a video about, like, how somebody compared, like, her net worth to, like, people in her same...
Like, in the same category what she does?
Yeah, like, yeah. People who, like, make the same amount of music, and they came out around the same time she did, and did the same, and, like, Britney Spears' numbers are, like, millions and millions and millions lower than these people.
They probably took so much money from her, bro. It's sad, man. I'm not gonna lie, like, if we're gonna get honest about something real quick, before we get off the Britney Spears topic, let's just say what, she's one of the GOATs, bro. Like, of music... Britney Spears is one of the GOATs. Like, that, you can't take that away from her, bro. Like, there's people, like, you know, right now how Drake is, like, Drake's beyond music and rap. We can both agree on that part. Britney Spears is that to music.
To, like, pop?
Yeah, there's certain people, bro, who have transcended music. Britney Spears is, like, to me, like, she's one of the GOATs of music, bro. Her impact and, like, the fan base she was able to get, her origin story, where she came from, bro, like, that, come on, you know what I mean? But yeah, comment below, guys, if you've seen what's been going on. That'd be cool if, like, by the end of the summer, she gets this shit ended, because that, you know, but yeah. So, on to something you might know more about. I know you know more about this. GTA 6. So there's a rumor that GTA 6 is going to be dropping in 2025. Is that a rumor, or is that something that has been...
It's a rumor at the moment, I guess.
So they haven't verified it. Rockstar.
Mm-mm.
Hmm. Well, it's 2021 now. So that's 4 more fucking years that we're going to have to wait for this game.
It might be 30 by the time it comes
out. I think it's time someone gets pistol whipped. What are we... You know what I mean? Like, are we waiting for the PS6 to come out? Is that what we're waiting for? Is that when GT... They dropped the trailer last year. Am I wrong?
No, that was for the PS5 version.
Of GTA 6.
Of GTA 5.
Oh, I thought they dropped a trailer for 6. Okay, I was about to go in. Because I was saying, you dropped the trailer, and now... Okay. So was there any indication that this game was going to drop sooner than 2025? Were there no indication of that?
No.
Okay, so maybe fans just hyped themselves up, because what fucking game, besides Cyberpunk... Right, Emily? When did Cyberpunk start getting made? It was like 2006. Or some Cyberpunk started like hella long ago, bro. Okay. So this is what happens. You cause hella hype for a game. Okay. Let's say it comes out in 2025, like they're saying, and then it's not as good as it's supposed to be. And then we're all hella angry. Like, where the fuck are the hookers at, bro? What are they going to do different? Okay, here's two things you can say off this. One, you know how they make Madden? They take the same engine from last year. It's the same fucking thing, bro.
No.
And then they just add a new roster.
No, it's gonna be completely different.
I know.
GTA 5 is based off of an engine that they made in 2013.
And you can tell. You could tell it's going to be different because they're taking their time. So yeah, fans can be mad and be like, oh, it's going to drop in 2025. Or you could be happy because it seems like they're taking their time and you're not going to get a Madden situation where they just reuse the same fucking thing and just dress it up as a different shit.
No, the only thing I'm worried about is if it comes out in 2025, the PlayStation 5 will be 5 years old, might even be at the end of its life cycle. So why even release it for that console? It's going to be like how they released it for the PS3. Yeah. And then the PS4 came out the very next year.
That might happen. That would suck. That
so
would
they're going to release it for the PS5 and then the very next year, like a PS6. Or
didn't the report say it was like supposed to be a modern day Vice City?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's not bad either.
They said it's going to change too. Like how...
It'll change cities?
No, like the map will evolve as time goes on.
Ooh, that's cool. See, okay, now take... Okay, now maybe...
They likened it to like Fortnite. Like Fortnite has a different map like every season.
So there'll be different maps like Vice City and then
no,
next
like
map.
It'll just be Vice City, I think. And then they'll just change how everything looks like maybe every year.
Oh, like stuff like businesses go out of business and that'd be freaky, bro. And that... You get into where those characters in GTA 6 think they're real, bro. And dude, you know what I'm saying? Like that's cool, bro. I like that type of shit. Because it furthers other stuff that I'm into. But, you know...
They said it's going to have multiple characters like how GTA 5 had.
I heard a rumor that there's a woman character, which is cool. I think that'd be cool. Why not? Let's make her a fucking Mexican girl, dude. Why not? Or Cuban. It says they're doing Vice City. Why not, bro? A modern day Cuban. Modern day Vice City. Modern day solutions for modern day problems, dude. But yeah, no. I'm super excited about that game because in number 5, you can hunt down like serial killers. And you could see UFOs, and it was good, bro.
The reason why I don't think it'll be another Cyberpunk situation, though, is because, like, GTA 5, maybe aside from, like, Minecraft, is, like, the biggest game to ever exist. So there's no way that GTA 6 is going to flop. I don't think there's anywhere.
Yeah,
it has to be,
Cyberpunk,
like, a really fucking bad game to flop.
Cyberpunk flopped hard, bro. Like, Emily still plays it, right? And she says even to this day, on the level she's at now, the game still skips and still has glitches and, you know, and there's people in like her little, like, I think it's like Reddit or something or wherever forum she reads it on, where people are saying the game is unplayable. That's how bad they think the glitches are.
I don't think it was made supposed to be for...
So when she plays Cyberpunk, bro, the funniest thing is like the cops will chase you, right? But the second you get in a car, they don't chase you. Like, what? She also showed me a part in Cyberpunk where you can't change the character's look. You know, like in GTA 5, you could change the haircut and shit. You can't do that in Cyberpunk.
I thought that was one of the main selling points, was you could.
Right, Emily? No? Did they change that yet? Yeah, see, they didn't change that. So, no, you can make them what you look like in the beginning to send. But once you get the game started, you can't change the look. So let's not ruin GTA 6 by putting in like some experimental things. Hey, for GTA 6, can't change the character's clothes. Let's see if fans like that one. You know, bro, there's certain decisions that these companies make that I think they're trolling. Because someone sat in an office and said, hey, once the game starts, you can't change the outfit. That's a good idea, right, guys? And everybody was clapping like, oh, great idea. Great idea, Bob. Bob thought he was so fucking cool when he went home that night. I guarantee you. Honey, I stood up. I raised my voice at the fucking table. And she's like, well, what happened? They're not going to be able to change clothes once the game starts. She's like, even his wife thought it was retarded, bro. Even his wife thought it was dumb. But yeah, I'm excited for that. Okay, and then before we end tonight's episode, you haven't seen Fast 9, have you?
No.
Okay, thank God, because I haven't. I haven't either, but I've been... watching the reviews and the memes. Let's just say it should have ended when Paul Walker died. I think it's about time we say that. I think it's cool now to say that. I think it's time to move on. Hey, Paul, it was a good run, bro. But we're not. If we go to 10, which Vin Diesel already said they're going to 10.
Yeah.
Sorry, Vin. You can't. Family's not going to save this one, bro. You can't, well, what? We started off racing cars and dealing drugs, bro. And stealing brick trucks. Remember when they got the DVDs from the truck? Yeah, so that's how we started. And now we're in space. We're in fucking space, Vin? I almost call him Vince Diesel. Vince Diesel, it's the same thing. But like, bro, we're in space now. To me, bro, and I haven't seen 8 either. The series ended at 7. When Paul Walker and Vin Diesel split their cars, it's been a long day without you, my friend. You know, when they split the cars, that's when the movie ends for me, bro. I'm sorry that the movie ends there.
I don't remember if I've ever
with
seen
Paul Walker's CGI'd brother's his brother's face with CGI'd on him. He's gonna leave without saying goodbye. Yeah, we know it's not Paul Walker, bro. It's Brian Walker, actually. Can you imagine, bro? That's where the series should have ended, bro. What even happened in 8? Have you seen 8?
No, that's what I just said. I feel like I have seen 8, but I literally don't remember what it was about.
I know the plot was like Charlie Theron was the villain, I believe. And like, he was, you know, in the trailer, it was like Dom's character was bad. And like, you didn't know why Dom's, like, why did Dom turn against his family? Right? Like, it was hella weird. Like in the trailer, he's like turning against his family and shit. It's because she was threatening to kill his kid, bro. So that's why he did that and like turned against his family and shit. It's because like, bro, like we go 7 movies where there's a barbecue at some point of the movie and they're grilling like vegetables and steaks. And Dom always does that speech. It's always the barbecue scene where Dom does that speech. He's like, oh, Dom, thank you. You know, like, oh, we almost died today. And then he's like, it's because of family. You know, or somebody's brother comes back to life. Somebody's dad's not really dead.
Yeah, no, I fucking hate the Fast series, dude.
Hey, 7 is where I should end it.
Everyone
huh?
just, yeah, like you said, everyone just comes back to life. Everyone's just like, hey, I didn't know Dom had a brother. It's he like, doesn't. Yeah, where is he at the fucking last 8 movies?
Yeah, Dom says family like 1,000 times.
But he doesn't mention his brother?
Yeah, brother. Yeah, you didn't want to mention your brother who knows how to shoot assault rifles and knows how to drive a car. You didn't want to mention that, bro?
Yeah,
hey, we could have known that 6 movies ago, dog. That you had a brother out here running around, bro, like a fucking terrorist. He knows how to shoot bazookas and he knows how to drive cars. Yeah, Dom, thank you, bro. You know what I mean? What?
I like a lot of the action scenes and stuff, but like now they're just like to the point where it's like way too unrealistic and like it like takes you out of the movie. To where like driving in space, like, oh wow, that's so fucking cool. But then like when you think about it, you just
yeah, when I saw that the other day, I saw that on Twitter. The car in space. I was like this. That's the first time besides Star Wars Episode 8 where I had to look at something and be like, a movie franchise that I love just died. Mm-hmm. I'm watching it die in front of me. When you see that car in space, should have ended at 7, by the way. But yeah.
Or the Hobbs and Shaw movie, which is technically, I guess, still part of that universe.
In the Fast universe.
The Rock was like, he had like a chain hook on a helicopter and was like pulling the helicopter. And it's like, bro, like, this is like a Marvel movie now.
Are they trying? Is it a joke though? Are they joking?
I don't know.
When did it? Because if they're not, hey, Vin Diesel, we don't want to see you guys in space. And we don't want to see The Rock pull down a helicopter with a chain. And to the fact that there's even a Hobbs and Shaw movie at all, what are we doing? I'd rather see Paul Walker's brother CGI'd on him again. Let's make a fucking Brian movie. I'd rather see a CGI'd Brian movie, knowing it's not Paul Walker, than to ever fucking watch Hobbs and Shaw. I'm sorry. There's people who watch it, huh? I guarantee you. There's someone right now watching this who feels like I'm attacking them. I saw Hobbs and Shaw. It was actually pretty good. Rotten Tomatoes gave it a. I don't give a fuck what Rotten Tomatoes gave it, bro. That sounds horrible to me. Hobbs and Shaw? Yeah, bro. No, actually. Could we get back to the street racing? Or are we just gonna fucking skip that? Did they even street race anymore? They didn't in 7. I don't remember that in 7. But it was cool because the movies were always Brian and Dom, bro. Once Paul Walker died, there's no more fucking Fast and the Furious for me, dude. Because nobody else can carry that movie. Paul Walker carried it, right? You think he carried a lot of movies. Like, out of all the movies in the saga, he kind of did carry a majority of them, right? Like, right? He was a good, like,
maybe,
you know?
Yeah.
But now, like, it just seems like everybody's phoning it in. They're probably at the table. Okay, we're going to say family 100 times. And Letty, I think we're just going to take a car into space. Okay, I mean, what else are we going to do? We're going to have Ludacris perform at the VMAs? What's his character's name in the movie? Ludacris? I don't know. Whatever. His character's name is Ludacris. Dude, Jesus Christ, dude. Yeah, I'm not watching that shit. I'm not watching Fast 9. And the fact that they're making a Fast 10, I want to puke. But yeah. And speaking of space, so that's what I wanted to end the episode on, was the UFO report. A couple weeks back, I did tell you guys about the report was going to be coming out. Like, it's, the rumor was June 1st. And like, they're like, hey, you know what I mean? They're so funny. Hey, the earliest is going to be June 1st. But technically, we don't have to release it till like the literal end of the month. Which I, you know, anybody in their goddamn right mind would have thought to themselves, like, yeah, they're not telling us about this shit till like the end of June. So that kind of got me worried at first because I was like, oh, they're just hyping us up, bro. They're not going to really say anything. That sucks. Because this is your real chance to actually tell people things. Let's be honest with the people who pay taxes. Or just humans in general, okay? Let's be honest with them for once. They didn't do that. Well, they did kind of, but it wasn't like as good as I thought it was. So before you showed up, bro, I was reading the UFO report. Like, it was only like 9 pages and like, you know, I wanted to read it. A lot of it was just like, you know, technical government mumbo jumbo. There was a couple things under that stood out. Like, they were talking about how the majority of these incidences have happened around military bases or like U.S. like air grounds, I believe. Like, you know, the air. But they said that they understand that sounds biased, but that's because they don't record other parts of the world. Like, you know, like if it's happening in China, we're not recording that, documenting that, because that's not us. That's basically what the report said. Like, hey, you know, we understand it sounds biased, but it's because this.
They're not out there like that.
Yeah, so that kind of, so just in America, let's say the government isn't lying, okay? Let's say the government is not lying, and that's actually happening, and they don't know what it is. Why do you think that those UFOs are only showing up around military bases or air grounds? If that's what the report's saying, is like the majority of the reports have been at those type of things. Why? Let's say the government's telling the truth. That's not them. It's not another country. They just literally don't know what it is. That was a fascinating part for the UFO report.
No, you just said, like, because, you know, why else would a military fighter jet be not near one of those? Like, what is it going to be doing in the middle of, like, fucking Nebraska or something? Yeah. How is a fighter jet going to see that when he has no business out there? I think it probably happens a shit more than we think, but, like, it just doesn't get reported because these officials aren't
taking it serious
in the middle of, like, fucking Arkansas or, you know, Wyoming.
Well, because a lot of them too, even from the footage that we've seen so far, a lot of them are going into water too, which means their ships can go underwater. Because they've been teaching us our whole life that water will crush you, because, you know, when you go underwater, you go too deep, the pressure will like crush you.
Mm-hmm.
So now it's cool because now we know that these ships can go underwater. Why are they underwater? Are they talking to our sea creatures? Is that why scientists want to know what whales are saying to us in? Bro, what if that, you know that report that me and Sebastian talked about? What if that's why scientists want to see what whales have to say? Bro, what?
Whales.
We have all these UFO videos that are like, the UFOs are going in the water, right? What if they're talking to whales and dolphins, dog? And that's why that report came out that scientists are like, yeah, we're trying to decode what whales are saying. Because, bro, that sounds like a conspiracy theory, but that's hella fire, dude. That's fucking fire, bro. So not only can they go underwater, that, you know, some of the report was saying, I believe, please edit the fact check into here because, you know, I believe it said out of 144 cases so far, that 143 can't be explained, that they've had on record, which 144 seems like such a small number.
So I'm saying,
there's probably more. I don't know, like, how what goes into this. But this was their chance to, like, actually be real with us for once and be like, hey, guys, we're going to be honest. We don't know what it is, but they're visiting us. You know why I don't think they will? I don't know how they're going to ever do this without, like, spilling the full truth. But I've said this to you before, bro. Like, I think the reason that they won't tell us is because these people come into our airspace and they don't have to check in with us. They don't tell us when they're coming. They just show up whenever they want and they can abduct whoever they want. I think that's the problem here. And I think the government, how do you tell your people that, bro? Like, you know, like don't you think people would panic? People would start panicking here. Like, they're kidnapping us without letting, like, bro, they can just come in here and do what they want? I mean, no one wants to be told that, right? And wouldn't that ruin your vision of the government? Because, like, you know, some people think the government can't be stopped and they can do whatever they want. What if you found out that there's something they can't control? They don't want you to know that, right? They don't want you to know that there's something they can't control, because then you guys are going to start rising up against them. Like, oh, they can't even stop aliens, bro. Let's go worship the aliens. See? Let's go get them to, let's go, you know what I mean, bro? Like that, another, sounds like another conspiracy theory, but that's, sounds good to me, dude. But yeah, the rapport is very underwhelming. So I'm so glad that I titled that video, like, is it going to be overhyped or overrated? Because it was overrated. They told us something that we already kind of know, right? But, like, they won't just, like, it kind of brings up another question, is why are these people so important that they're the only people that get to know? Like, why do they get to know? Is there something that, I don't get it, you know what I mean? Like, is there something that is special about them, or? And, like, if an alien is able to come here, how does it know that that person's, like, the leader of our country? Why doesn't it just go to some random human and be like, hey, why does it only have to show itself to, like, military people?
They probably, I don't know, they probably know who's who we look up to, not look up to, but, you know.
Well, okay, if you were looking at an anthill, would you be able to tell who the queen of the anthill is?
Yeah, for sure.
They or can. Like, or the, okay, like bees, I know. And shit too. Okay, that's a stupid excuse. They can, because the queen bee does look different, and the queen, yeah. But would you be able to tell, like, why this ant, these ants go this way, and why? Like, I don't know. Like, would an alien be able to even look at us and know what we are doing? Like, how does it know what we're doing? That's the creepiest part, bro. But the good, I think the silver lining in this report is that it kind of, like, softly prepares you for what's about to happen. So when stuff says, when stuff gets fucking very real, you're prepared. But there's also people at us who say, like, what if they, whatever they said in the report, you almost have to not trust it because of who it's coming from. You know, the government's like, okay, aliens and UFOs are real. Now, I don't know if I believe them. But is that what they want? See how far that rabbit hole can go? That's insane, dude. How do we know that that's not what's happening right now? Because everything's compartment. There's a word that I want to say. It's compartment. Compartmentalized. Ah, Jesus. Fuck, dude. Basically, like, everything's grouped, right? So let's say you have a group of 20 people and you divide them by 4. Or you divide them by 5, okay? This group is told this, they don't know nothing else. This group is told this, they don't, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So all together, you get a full puzzle, but in broken up pieces, you're not getting the full story, right? That's how they say they do that. And then there's only a couple actual group of people who actually know the true truth, which, imagine being them. But yeah, to end the UFO report, it's not much, guys. Yeah, I know, I'm bummed out too, but what I'm more excited for is, like, people who are starting to do their own, like, digging, and they watch their own videos, and they watch their own, like, you get to your own conclusion. Stop listening to everybody else, bro. Like, it's, have you ever heard of that school in Zimbabwe where, like, all the students were at recess and saw a UFO and an alien? Okay, I'm hoping I'm not butchering this story, like, completely crazy, but it was a school in Zimbabwe. These kids are on the kids are at recess, okay? The teacher's inside. Now, I'd have to read the article again to whether it was all the kids or a huge amount of kids at this recess saw an object in the sky, like, descend towards them, and then aliens come out of it. So these kids see the aliens, bro. And these aliens are talking to them, like, telepathically. The kids go inside. They tell their teacher that, you know, they're super upset. And I guess years later, now that they're adults, they say the same story. Like, they tell the same story. They don't change up their story from when they were kids. Like, you know, so it's fascinating that, like, stuff like that has happened. And, like, no one talks about that. Like, no one gives, like, people are just willing to ignore that story. Like, that's fucking insane. But yeah. Yeah, comment below, guys, if you've seen the UFO report. If and I'm pretty sure most of you will agree with me. That shit was hella underwhelming, bro. But yeah, so hopefully next week for See What's Real, the 2-year anniversary video, I'm so hoping we get Warren back. That'd be amazing. Let's keep your positive thoughts, bro, because it's going to happen. And yeah, episode 36 was a pleasure. Until next time, guys.